Welcome back. In today's video, I'll be showing you 10 easy ways to save battery life and extend the time needed between charges on a MacBook. This should work on any MacBook Air or Pro running macOS, although some of the methods might be slightly different depending on the exact version of macOS you are running. You don't need to follow all of the methods to extend your battery life, so feel free to skip some if you have already done them or you don't think that they will work. Battery life will also heavily depend on how old your device is, but hopefully the methods will still make a difference, no matter the age. Remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe if the video helps. Let's get into the methods. The first method is to close and stop apps from running in the background. You should be able to close a lot of the apps when you aren't using them to save battery life. Apps running in the background will still use system resources and therefore use battery. If you see the small circle below the app on the dock at the bottom of the screen, it means that the app isn't fully closed. Make sure you fully close an app in order to prevent it from using the resources of your Mac. To ensure an app is fully closed, open it and first make sure any work is saved. You can use the keyboard shortcut of Command and the Q key to fully close it. You may need to hold down this key combination on certain apps for it to close. Let's move on to the next method. The second method is similar to the first. We're now going to focus on preventing startup apps. These apps will run automatically when you turn on your MacBook, and they might run in the background and use resources. To stop apps from starting automatically when you start your MacBook, first go to System Preferences. You can get there by clicking on the Apple icon in the top left, and then by choosing System Preferences from the list. Within System Preferences, click on Users and Groups. It should be somewhere on the second row. In here, choose your profile from the list on the left. Now go to the Login Items tab. It will probably be next to the Password tab. You should now be able to see the list of applications that will run automatically when you start your MacBook. To stop a program from running at startup, select it in here by clicking on it once, and then click on the minus icon. You can always add it again in the future by clicking on the plus icon and then navigating to where it is stored on your MacBook. This will likely be the Applications folder. Let's move on to the third method. Method 3 is to lower the brightness of your device. You should be able to do this easily by using the lower brightness button on the keyboard. You can also reduce the brightness of the keyboard light. This won't save much battery life, but should make some difference. To lower the brightness of the keyboard backlight, first go to and click on the options icon in the top right. This is the icon to the left of the time and date. In here, click on the option called keyboard brightness, and then simply drag the bar to the left to lower the brightness of the keyboard. We'll now move on to the fourth method. The next method to save battery life on your MacBook is to make sure Bluetooth and Wi-Fi are turned off when not in use. Even if you have no devices connected to Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, it will still use battery. In some cases, it could use so much battery that turning it off will make a noticeable difference. To turn off Bluetooth or Wi-Fi when not in use, go back to the options icon that we used in the last method for keyboard brightness. It's in the top right of the screen. This time, just click on the Bluetooth or Wi-Fi icon if they are coloured blue, and this should turn it grey, indicating it is turned off. Let's move on to the next method. The fifth method is to keep your software updated. Out of date software can cause compatibility issues, and it is possible that these and similar problems can cause extra battery usage because of less optimization. To check for updates and see if you have the latest update, head to the Apple icon in the top left and click on that. Now click on About This Mac from the list. It should be at the top. In here, make sure you are in the Overview tab. This should be the furthest left option. Click on the Software Update button and then it should begin to check if there are any updates available. If there are, follow these steps to install it, but remember to save and close any work you have open, as your system will probably restart. Now that we have the latest software update, let's move on to method 6. The sixth method is to disconnect any devices when you aren't using them. This can include devices such as USB flash drives, external drives, mice, keyboards, and more. These devices will obviously use a small amount of battery power that can be saved if you unplug them when they aren't being used. Method 7 is up next. The seventh method is to check and see which apps use the most battery. This will allow us to limit usage on the most power-hungry apps. A quick way to see which apps use the most battery is to use the activity monitor. You can get to the activity monitor by using Spotlight Search. In the activity monitor, go to the energy tab and wait a moment. You should see the energy impact column give you numbers on the power usage of each app. Use this info to see which apps use the most energy and close them if you can, or at least limit the amount of time you spend using them. You can also go into the CPU tab to get similar information based on how much apps use the CPU and GPU. Let's move on to the next method. Method 8 is to customize some of the battery settings on your MacBook. To get to the battery settings, first go to System Preferences. You can get there by clicking on the Apple icon in the top left and then by choosing System Preferences from the list. Within System Preferences, click on Battery. Now that you are in the battery settings, there are a few ways to help with saving battery life. In the battery tab, you can change settings relating to when on battery, such as the display brightness and battery optimization settings. In the power adapter tab, you can change settings for when connected to power. All of these settings are up to you, but obviously the more you change to help with battery, the more noticeable the saving will be. We'll now move on to method 9. The ninth method is to use Lite versions of apps if they are available, and also change settings within apps and games to save battery life. Certain apps may have separate versions that are designed to use less resources and therefore battery. Alternatively, have a look in the settings for the apps you use for any battery saving options. In games, for example, you could lower the resolution or maximum frame rate to help limit the battery usage of that app. As these settings will be different in every app, it's difficult to show you any specific examples. Let's move on to the final method. The 10th and final method to save battery life on your MacBook is to take care of your MacBook and its battery in order to optimize its life and capacity. This can include things like charging at the right time and to the right amount, ensuring temperatures are within the recommended range, or allowing for ventilation on devices with fans. Thankfully, Apple has a lot of helpful resources to assist you in this. I'll leave a link in the description that will take you to the official Apple site for their advice on batteries. And so those are my 10 easy ways to save battery life on your MacBook. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you 10 easy ways you can speed up your macOS device. Help support the channel by visiting the store, the link is in the description and at the end of the video. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below. And if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.